What's up, everyone? I recorded this video on April 4th, 2022. It's a Monday afternoon, 1:20 p.m., 50 degrees Fahrenheit, 10 degrees Celsius. And I'm going to show you Boston's historic North End today. It's known as Boston's Little Italy, even though it's not officially called a Little Italy, but there are a lot of Italian restaurants and stores here. And we're going to be seeing some of them today. Down there is downtown Boston at the intersection of Endicott Street and Causeway Streets. And this over here is the North Washington Street Bridge. Very busy intersection. I don't even think the lights are working, and they have the safety officers directing people where to go. But let's explore the North End. Here we've got Filippo, Ristorante, and Functions. I don't think many of these restaurants will open until later, since their main meal is the dinner time, but it is the middle of the afternoon, so maybe we'll see some lunch spots open. Here's the other side of it. Yeah, it doesn't look like it's open right now. Looks like the school is fully modernized, the Elliott Innovation School. Also a nice playground across the streets. Actually more like a tennis court and a basketball court, but kids are playing in it. This is not the well-known area of the North End. Its main street is Hanover Street, which we'll be going to shortly. It's about like 4 or 5 blocks down from here. I think we have to go the other side of the street. It's all blocked off. So these are the narrow streets of Boston's North End. The homes here are some of Boston's oldest designs. Well, here's the neighborhood playground. This over here feels like a Zen garden, North End DiFilippo Children's Rock Garden. They put it all in the design of a heart. Find it interesting how UPS has to personally deliver the packages down this block. The vehicle's probably too big to fit down the street. There's also a lot of hills in Boston. Here we can see one of them. There we see the contrast between the north end and then the modern skyscrapers of downtown, which is this one over here is still on the construction. The old mom and pop silk screening business. Really nice. Custom lettering, vans, trucks, windows. Lots of custom artwork. Famous Italian bread here, Bova's Bakery, open 24 hours. Wow. Monica's Trattoria. Must be delivery time now. We've got DHL and UPS all to work. All right, so over here is the North End's most famous street, Hanover. Since we're entering in the middle of it, I'm going to walk to the beginning and then walk back up. It's a good amount of places that are open right now for lunchtime.
Damn it.
Including the most, one of the most famous places in the North End, Mike's Pastry, which probably has the best tasting cannoli I've ever had. This place always has a line, no matter what time of day it is.
Hey, Raiden, relax.
Raiden.
Cash only.
Oh, sorry.
For Mike's Pastry. No, it's okay. Italian cafe. Wow, this restaurant, I guess, has multiple locations for different purposes. Trattoria 2, Panino, Assaggio, Acqua, Pazza.
Nice, that's yeah. Right. Yeah. You can walk across the street and catch it.
That's right.
Yeah. That's perfect.
I told
Support
to bring you the
dressing
room.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is the first original Trattoria. Dolce Bakery, Gelateria, Pizzeria, and Cafe. Oh my gosh, this looks so good. Big muffins, they've got Sicilian pizza, Italian sandwiches, and of course the gelato. We got two menus up, the lunch and the dinner.
But I was also confused why she didn't take me to the restaurant.
is the location of CVS, which stands for Consumer Value Store. And we have reached the boundaries of the North End with downtown Boston right across from us. By the way, I forgot to mention about this brick-lined road here. This is part of the Freedom Trail. And if you follow the Freedom Trail, it takes you through many historical sites, such as the Boston Tea Party and also the Massachusetts State House and the Boston Common. All right, now wrap around the other side of the street and I'll show you the rest of Hanover. Mother Anna's restaurant. It's a much different atmosphere at nighttime. They look like they've gotten cannolis from Mike's Pastry there. That looks so good. Really, the best sandwiches down this alleyway? Oh my gosh. It certainly smells very good in here. Let's go inside, best of Boston. Smells like olive oil in here. Hi. This is so cool. There's a hidden bakery back here. The flour, the yeast in the oven. There's also a tiny seating area. And also another side over here. No wonder why I smell olive oil. They have a big sign that says olives. Okay. Star Diamond Award. I can tell Italian pastries are a big thing here in the North End. This one was established in 1930. The modern pastry shop.
like 4 hours.
They make all their pastas fresh on the premise daily. That's what it says.
Good, I guess, but...
This place over here looks very busy. People waiting outside already for Carmelina's in North End. Go down this way, check out the historic church here. Sacred Heart Italian Church. And I believe over here, this is the Paul Revere house. That's where the Freedom Trail wants you to go in front of. I think there is a statue of Paul Revere in the North End, further along Hanover Street. Wait, the entrance is open? Are we allowed to go in? Groups begin every 10 minutes. So it looks like this place really specializes in pizza. And the statue of Paul Revere must be over here where all these people are gathered. Yes, it says the Paul Revere Mall. Here's the Old North Church. Oh wait, this is they call this the New North to distinguish from the Old North. So the Old North Church must be down that way. It's a great picture of, great statue of Paul Revere here. I think I'll walk over to the Old North Church over there and I'll end this video. And here is the Old North Church, established in 1793. Unfortunately, it looks like the gate is locked, so we're not able to walk into the courtyard. Anyway, this concludes my video of Boston's North End. Really hope you enjoyed it. Smash the like button if you did. And I will see you next time. Take it easy, everyone. Bye-bye.